about it. Unfortunately, gave away his positioning. But now we're going to switch gears. Next game, Jake Kubacki here, your elimination leader in this game. We're at 25 duos, 43 players remain. And we're at everyone's favorite spot. What is your go-to phrase? Your catchphrase, yeah? No, that was it.
Yeah, yeet?
Yeah, I was hoping you'd yell it.
Oh, unfortunately, no, I just read their names. That wasn't even me trying to be funny. Those people's names were O and A.
Well, you know, at least someone on not too far away, Golden Boy, far away from us right now, is dying of laughter. But E11's Daxlor and Grazka, two very potent duos here.
And you see on the top right of your screen, starting to cut you off, Zeke, exactly how many players, or how many teams, sorry, qualify from each region. So the top three duos qualify this week. Again, remember, the top 1,500 duos qualified for tomorrow, where of those 1,500 duos, the top three make it to New York.
Yeah, I mean, you really have to show up tomorrow. You obviously want to hit enough points to make sure you make it on through tomorrow. You don't want to give away too many of your strategies, right? You don't want to give away your landing spots or anything that you don't want anyone else around you knowing. Because I promise you, you keep landing in a place, and the word's going to get around.
Well, yeah, I've played in a bunch of these now, these recent weeks with different skilled players, and qualified each time for the Sunday event, whether it was the test ones, the Lux, anything like that. My biggest takeaways that I had, if you're someone competing, is first, don't limit yourself to one drop. Mm. And two, make sure no matter where you plan to go, you have a backup option.
Yeah.
Everyone knows those games where you go, we're not low enough, or how did this team land so well? You know, I can't challenge that. Make sure you both are on the same page with where you're going to go. Or if it's not going to work out, make sure one of you doesn't land there and the other one lands far away. Teamwork makes the dream work, especially off the break of the game. And man, talk about another harsh rotation. We cannot even see the edge of the zone. Look what's going up. It's going up this side of this mound again. Sorry to keep harping on it, but it's just been funny. We've had some rough rotations. Where's our middle of fatal field zone? Look at this. Everyone's having a launch pad from down low.
Yeah, we're going to see these players try to change elevation, get up there as quickly as possible, and 90 up to get to safety.
And now why I think this one's not going to be as bad as the other, Zeke, is because this is still early on the moving zones, so most players here will still have their rotation items left, whether it's the launch pad, the rift to goes, and they can just use them and realize, hey, we need to use them for this elevation. Sure, would they like to save them for maybe a little bit later on in this game? Maybe, but right now it's the lesser of two evils, just to survive and not die to the storm. Players beginning to drop like flies, though. 24 players remaining, 16 duos in total. On over to Neff and Liquid Fiber, who are now at 5 elims combined.
They just got that first set of valuable placement points. This is huge for them. And here, we got to see where the next zone is going. Keep an eye on that bottom mini-map. Now we're going back north. So potentially over old builds, potentially more mountain ranges to have to try and fight over, 90 your way up. It's going to be tough. It's going to be real tough.
Smart play by Neff to just go ahead, back on up, keep this high ground. Nothing they need to force. They've already got high ground. They're both alive with, you know, a combined 350 HP, and you can laser from up top. There goes Ryze Ronaldo, name we've seen many times before in previous competitions. They're matching the layer of these builds. Beautiful crack with the pump shotgun right there, and time for the W key. Yeah, there goes Lezion. They do have, I think they do have to drop down a little bit, though, because now they've gone down the elevation. Yeah.
I would have probably come down.
Okay, there they are. Even just a couple levels. They don't have to waterfall too far. Yeah, that's it. That's it. Smart play. I could just tell it was looking a little bit too much of a fall right there.
Dios there going down.
And this is going back again.
Mm-hmm. So
we're going back where we came from again. So when you mention old builds still being in play, what you have to remember is now when they're getting lower and lower on materials remaining, it is so key to still have that cover from what you previously built to still use that. Look at this. Right on through those builds. Kohlhart, Daxor, Loom, Gilly, Cubics, they can all be running through their old builds and be able to save materials.
We're going to have to see what happens because Nephrux here is trying to contest with Fiber. It looks like they might have taken away that high ground. Keep in mind, guys, there's 7 players left, 5 duels, so another set of placement points. This player in the 1v1 down below is getting lasered, and Nephrux turns his attention, eliminates Kohlhart. This is good. That's one less player to worry about, and that Siphon is going to come on through. More shots, nothing to connect. I like that Fiber is kind of keeping his distance from Nephrox. They're just trying to split attention, right? Make sure there's two different angles coming through.
When you have a health advantage, when you have 200 HP and the other players don't, or you have the high ground, What is the one way you make sure you can't just be have a coin flipped on you at any moment? That's staying out of shotgun range. The only things that can one-shot you at this point, basically, in the game is a 220 damage pump shot. These two want to make sure that that's not an option. That's why they keep the level like, look, Neff got a little bit too close right there off the bat. Now Xur challenging for the high ground. It's an all-out build battle. The launch pad used. Xur now up on the high ground. The other two look like they're probably going to wind up dying to this storm. No, Neff has made it on in. Love on the edge as well. Xur with the high ground, but Fiver with more HP.
This is really tough. It's a 2v2, and right now,
no. Oh, Fiver read that perfectly. Notice Xur was held up by
Rotoram. Oh, my God!
There's the shotgun shot. One-on-one. Lum and Fiver. Fiver chasing it, and there it is. Lum falls to his death, and you see Fiver cranks the 90s to end it. Brilliantly done. Right there with both players building on up because Fiber decided not to match the build of his opponent who went above him in that build battle, he saw the weakness.